For weeks, they've been flooding the streets, young and old, by the thousands. Many holding candles, standing, they say, so their democracy won't be extinguished. Today, they won a major battle.
As you walk through this crowd today, you can tell how different the mood here is. That's because these people here aren't protesting, they're celebrating.
In a surprise move, appearing to bow to the protesters' demands, Poland's President Andrzej Duda refused to sign a controversial bill that would have allowed the country's ruling party to replace every judge on the Supreme Court.
This law, which has been passed through Parliament, will not come into effect. Those laws have to be amended so that they can be adhered to and admitted and agreed by everyone.
The bill had drawn widespread condemnation from both the EU and the United States, with Poles taking to the streets saying the new law would give the ruling party unprecedented power, edging Poland closer to the old days of authoritarian rule.
When young people and all the people go out on the streets for a reason, the government and right now the president, he listened to us.
The question is, what happens now? The president is sending the law back to parliament. They can either revise it or scrap it altogether. Today, Poland's vice minister of justice, a member of the ruling party, insisted the justice system is corrupt, inefficient, and badly needs a much bigger overhaul.
We will have to discuss the new shape of the disciplinary procedures against the judges, or we can talk about the new law. But one thing is certain, the ethical standards will have to be restored.
Despite the looming threat of a new law, for now at least, protesters are still calling this a victory.
The message to the young people right now in Poland is, you have to go out on the streets every time when you see that the law that is against the constitution is passed in the parliament.
And for now, in the eyes of thousands of protesters, that flame of a free and healthy democracy lives on. Muhammad Lila, CNN, Warsaw.